There have been many studies. There are boring studies, and I don't mean that they're not exciting. I'm talking about boring through the rock. And there are people that have actually gained, geologists who have gained access to boring through the structures. Unfortunately, the geologists they have chosen may lack the credibility that we would want for this study. Geologists connected with this Sphinx Atlantis theory and have been part of that, and we can assume that most of their work is damaging. It's not correct, and I demonstrate that online. I cannot say it unless I can demonstrate, and I urge you to go to the website and check it out. But by doing looking at the drawings, I can demonstrate on the south side of the Great Pyramid, there is actually a natural hill on the south side, as well as the northeast corner. The south side's unique because three of the four sides of the Great Pyramid are virtually very close to the exact same length in size. The south side is out of measure in comparison to the other three sides. In a unique way, and I explain this in book two of my series, that the mismeasurement, the miscalculation of the south side is actually representative by a hill that exists. And I demonstrate in the photos that there are structures, and they have actually torn away stones in past times exploring this structure and found that they actually wound up digging into the side of a hill. In a unique way, the masking of the concept of the hills has obscured our quarry ideas, our construction ideas, our rock mobilization and sled ideas, and it's completely confused us in so many ways that we have failed to see the truth. And I demonstrate this all very clearly, and it doesn't take a rocket scientist. It just takes somebody who wants to rock the world.